In this video, you'll learn how to connect Google Analytics to Meta. This lets you see your advertising data from Facebook ads, Instagram ads, and other Meta ads in your reports. We're going to look at the new Meta Cost Data Import feature that Google has just announced. The great thing about this is that it's free to use and it can pull up to 24 months of historical advertising data into your reports. There are a few important things you will need to set this up, so I recommend watching until the end before you start setting things up in your property. Okay, let's head to Google Analytics to take a look. I've already logged into my Google Analytics demo account and navigated to Admin. To connect Meta and import our advertising data, we can select Data Import, or we can select Data Collection and Modification on the left, and then choose Data Import. In order to set this up, you will need editor or administrator permission for the Google Analytics property. If you don't have the correct level of permission, you'll need to have your permission increased or get someone with the correct permission to set things up. Since I do have the correct level of permission for this property, let's click Create Data Source. Now we need to name our data source. I'm going to name mine Meta Ads. Next, ensure that cost data is selected. Then at the bottom, let's change the import source to Meta. And let's click Connect. A pop-up opens, and we need to authorize access so that data is shared with Google Analytics. Let's approve this. And let's click Next. Now we need to select our Business Center account. And we need to select our ad account. Okay, now we're at the most important step. We need to map the Google Analytics UTM Source and UTM Medium campaign tags to the values we use in our Meta ads. This means if you're not using Google Analytics campaign tags with your ads, you won't be able to import data yet. You will need to start using these first. If you would like to learn more about how to use campaign tags, then please check out my dedicated tutorial and my Google Analytics course. I've included links to these in the description below this video. Let's take a quick look at the campaign tags used for one ad in Meta. To do this, let's head to Meta Ads Manager. We're looking at the destination settings for a traffic campaign. And let's select Build a URL parameter. We can see the campaign tags applied to the ad. The two most important ones we want to make a note of are the campaign source and the campaign medium. For this ad, campaign source is using a dynamic URL parameter of site source name. This will automatically adjust the value for the UTM source parameter depending on where the ad is seen and clicked. For example, if someone sees the ad on Facebook, this will have a value of FB. And looking at campaign medium, we can see this is hard-coded with a value of paid. Now that we've confirmed our ad is using campaign tags, let's head back to Google Analytics. Since I'm using the dynamic site source name parameter, I'm going to enter the values it uses for each of the UTM parameters. However, if you're using different values with your campaign tags, you should enter those instead. Okay, I'm going to enter FB for the Facebook source, then IG for Instagram, AN for audience network, MSG for Messenger, I'm going to skip threads, and for medium, I'm going to enter paid. Now let's click Next. You have the option of adjusting when data is imported, and you can also apply filters if you only want certain campaigns or advertising data to be available in Google Analytics. Then when you're ready, you can click Finish. Your data source for Meta will now be created. Depending on how much historical data needs to be imported, it can take some time for everything to appear in your reports. In terms of reporting, you will be able to find metrics including clicks and cost for your Meta ads in the default non-Google cost report, which is available under Acquisition in the standard reports. And you can also create exploration reports that include your imported data. If you'd like me to create a video covering these reporting options, please let me know in the comments. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel for more updates and tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.